Well, this time it's Women's Student Eights, the Islands Challenge Cup. On the far side, in effect, it's the Oxford University boat race crew. On this near side, it's the women from Imperial College London. They run Putney on the Thames, Oxford obviously. They train up in Oxford, the river down there at Wallingford. And I think it's great that Coach Andy Nelder has brought these Oxford women into this contest to try and bring them on for the 2024 boat race.
Yeah, and here we go back to a live shot of the race. You can see it's sort of starting to settle down, and both crews have settled into their race rhythm.
Yeah, and interesting is the back of Laurel Kay. I think she's studying astrophysics at Oxford. I talked to her during the boat race, and she is a doctor. She's got, you know, a double degree, and she's going to go back and I think be a medic in the US. So this boat is stroked by Esther Austin, who is a Kiwi, the 30-year-old. She was back as a junior, I think, way back in 2010. Sarah Marshall in the seven seat, Claire Aitken, Alison Carrington, Freya Willis. They're all so familiar names. Sophie Cammy, I think, in the three seat is maybe the one who wasn't in the actual boat race crew. Ella Stadler in the two seat. You can see her there with a little green top underneath that rowing suit. And Laurel Kay, we've already spoken about the bow. Zach White in the coxswain's seat, doing a great job. He didn't cox this crew in the boat race, but he certainly is enjoying this outing down the course.
And here we go again, one of your favorite shots there, Martin, for a quick minute. Both boats coming down with the umpire's launch right in the middle.
Yeah, we've got Imperial College, which is a fantastic club to row for. Pete Hardcastle, the great Australian Olympian, made the games in 2000 and was at your games in 2004, Akhil, Australian Sculler in 2008 as well. And he's really got a great program. And the cox from Imperial, she said, she's written, she said, love it. You know, she's talked of the honour to pull on the IC all-in-one and cox not just this women's eight, but the men's eight as well into the regatta. And it's made even more special by her recent election as captain the next year. So there we go. That's the coxswain from the Imperial College boat. And she's really focused in this contest. Let's have a look at the Oxford boat. There's Laurel Kay right up in the bow. She looks so cool, doesn't she?
Yeah, she looks really relaxed there. Nice and long, really applying some great pressure. You can see not a lot going on there. Nice and relaxed. I really like how she's getting really good length there.
I think Andy Nelder did a great job with this crew. I mean, they lost the boat race to Cambridge, but they were right in contact. You know, they could have gone for the bump just before Hammersmith Bridge, that Oxford crew, and maybe Cambridge would have, you know, been beaten if that's the case and been disqualified. But he's kept this crew together. You can see the spirit, because it's unusual to see a boat race crew with so many athletes.
Yeah, here we have this close-up of Imperial. There you go. You can see the stroke, Leah Kopix. And, you know, she's there. She's giving it her all. She's still nice and relaxed as they give their best to try to see if they can eat anything back into that Oxford lead.
Yeah, and just looking at the forewoman, Lauren Bowles, she's a Henley winner in 2023 in the academic four minors. But she's come into this regatta. She rowed on the other side, so she is now rowing on stroke side. I think she rowed on bow side, so that's port to starboard. Mm. So basically, she's changed sides. How difficult is that for her?
Yeah, it's pretty difficult. I started on port, and then I switched over to starboard out of necessity for our crew at university. And I tell you, it's a little bit different to try to figure out what side you're on, and the mechanics are a little bit different. But, you know, great athletes can make these changes, and, you know, she's put in the work, she's put in the time, and by this time, she's probably got that side down.
20 strokes to go, and it is the women from Oxford University Women's Boat Club who are leading this heat of the Island Challenge Cup for student women's eights. From Imperial College, you can just see them on the left of your picture, and it is the women from Oxford who come up to take the win in this heat of the Island Challenge Cup. ahead of Imperial, rode really well the Imperial women, but just faced by a crew that have had a lot of cohesion, a lot of togetherness, real spirit in the crew, and take them on to the 2024 boat race campaign and to tomorrow's race in this contest.
Yeah.